What do you think is the role that we as industry can play to make the big shift on bringing real focus onto action, which impacts everyday issues to do with sustainability, to do with people practices? And governance, again, since you are at ESG, governance is one more issue which has actually been a big bother over the last few decades. The large number of scams and scandals one has heard in companies, in cities, in countries, amongst leaders in all walks of life has been a big disruptive force in smooth growth across the board. So are there things that we as industry can do to help smoothen this entire path?
So thank you, Chairman. I think what I will first do is to sort of triangulate what I've seen in the last 1 year or so. We've actually traveled 25 cities. This time I decided to Bharat Bhramanant just to understand what is really going on the ground and how do we connect up to what businesses can do. I think I'll come to that point. And I think much of it has been highlighted. What we see on the ground, you've seen that whole issue related to jobs and skills, which has been highlighted already. There is a pain in our MSME sector. I mean, while the economy is growing, I think we need to figure out how to deal, engage with it. And lastly, coming to the point which I think Mohandas Pai highlighted in terms of trade, I think we can't just be isolationists. We need to engage with the world. And that's our internal issue with all the positives, you know, all the positives of agrarian productivity increasing, which is leading to more people coming into cities. It can be viewed positive or negative. And also, you look at education, women's education now is almost at, you know, at the graduation level, getting at parity of men's education in terms of, so there are many, many pluses there, but that's also creating huge challenges for us. And then when you look at external environment, you know, we know about the broken geopolitics, but really what it is leading to in daily people's life is there's a cost of living crisis. That's due to broken supply chain, and secondly, due to geopolitics, which is pushing up basic energy cost. I mean, and there's a jobs crisis, there's a skills crisis coming out of all digital AI, everything. And small businesses worldwide, it's not just in India, are under pressure, I mean serious pressure. And then top it off, I think we've got trade barriers and non-trade barriers, which are really sort of, again, pushing up this cost of living. Now, I think India's role in this is to see through this problem and at least play the role of responsible leadership. And I just want to say the word responsible is very critical. And therein lies also the opportunity for Indian business. Firstly, I think we need to think ahead and say the world forward will be more interconnected and we must make sure it gets interconnected. Secondly, you must engage. You know, this point about I want to engage with this part, I want to engage with that part doesn't help anybody. And there's no dialogue. I think that piece has to be, I think the lead has to be taken. And maybe India is taking that lead. And lastly, we have to be forward-looking. I think we can't be saying that solutions which worked in the past will work in future. Some of them may work. Some of them will be opportunities we need to move forward. So really, the opportunity for Indian businesses is to engage in the manner to say that it is not India only, but it is India and the world where we are going to be connecting with you, we are going to be making sure that we are going to engage with you, and we are going to be the solution providers for future. And many things are in our favor. Let me just say this. Firstly, you look at innovation, that stuff which is happening in space, stuff opportunity which is there in nuclear. I think these are all huge opportunities to change the energy landscape, the opportunity landscape, bioresources, marine resources, and then stack that up with AI digital. I think you've got a perfect recipe for rebuilding and reimagining the future. And then the bottlenecks really are around, you know, our issues of energy and that needs to get addressed, logistics, skills and talent, which are softer aspects. And in many ways, the behavior change begins to happen only in two ways, in my view. We have all studied in management since we are in an All India Management School. And we all know about this Johari window. I mean, if you go back and say, listen, what is the framework we need to use? And Johari window says that if you want to improve yourself and you want to be forward-looking, there are only two things you need to do, which is self-disclosure, and secondly, engage in feedback. That's what leads to improvement, by the way. And ESG reporting, as you said, being ahead of the curve is very much part of that self-disclosure. We are saying, listen, this is what we are, however good, bad, ugly it is, but we have a pathway forward, and that leads to feedback coming to us to say, what do we do next? So we've said many things. For example, some of the things are very difficult because we are in hard to abate sector, especially steel, power, chemicals, these are all, and airline, my colleague from airline is here, I think very difficult to abate sector. But you said by 2030, each company will have a specific target. Most companies have said 30% reduction in carbon. We said by 2045, we will be net zero across the company. But after having done this work, I think most companies are on that path. So the surprising thing is, once you put a number out on the ground, teams figure out, I don't know how these solutions are coming. We said we'll be more circular. We're going to work on biodiversity. Difficult challenges, but this is one piece of the puzzle which we're wanting to do. And we, all our companies, those which are listed, not listed, are going to sort of report on this and engage on this. And the piece around this, as you mentioned, is this, there is an element of governance standard which comes out of what I call as transparency. Are you being transparent? See, the first level is reporting, second level is disclosure, third level is, you know, transparency. Transparency is a philosophy itself. And I think as long as Indian businesses are moving in the direction of let's be more transparent, I think we will probably get the solution and engage with the world in a positive way.
If you like the video, do like, comment, share, and subscribe.